What's the best thing about Stockport?
How fast you can get out of it.
But it's huge.
It is the source of the River Mersey.
Or it could be the infamous pyramid.
The world famous viaduct.
The viaduct.
Apparently Fred Perry is from Stockport.
Fred Perry.
Worst thing about Stockport.
People walking to the shops in their pyjamas.
Well, I don't really know.
250 million years ago, Stockport was part of an ancient desert.
There's everything that you could possibly want and more.
Stockport's the place to be.
Mark Steele's in town.
Thank you. Thank you very much, and welcome to Mark Steele's in town, which this week comes from the beautiful village of Stockport. Famous for its cream teas at the Merseyway shopping centre and its gentle farming folk of Adswood. It's a cultured town, Stockport. There's an account on Twitter called Twitter on Stockport, and a typical comment I saw was, my driving instructor used to say, we'll drive up to Bramall today to catch the MILFs on their score runs. Millions of people in this country every day mention Stockport when they're on a train and go, oh, brilliant, we're coming into Manchester. Oh, sod it, it's Stockport. I always forget about Stockport. When you pass through Stockport station, you can see a sign that shows what Stockport has to offer. It says Stockport, home of Stockport College. That is marketing, isn't it? The railway station here has also come up with a marvellous scheme. There's a tunnel that people walk through to get from Edgeley to the city centre, and they put ticket inspectors on either end. So that now you need a rail ticket to walk through the tunnel. Because it's only fair that if you want to walk through an underpass, you should have to buy a peak time return to Bristol for 380 quid. But Stockport is surprising. Firstly, because no one can decide where it is. To start with, it was in Lancashire, then it became part of Cheshire, then Greater Manchester, then Cheshire again, then some bits in Cheshire and some bits in Manchester. Now, most of it's in Cheshire, so you have to wonder if this confuses some people who say, well, we've booked up a little weekend break in Cheshire and they're hoping to relax with some wine and take a ramble across the downs and rather cheaper than we thought in a little spot called Edgeley. Only drawback is if we wish to stroll into the town centre, we've got to buy a peak time return ticket. But Stockport is huge with hundreds of bits. There's the not so posh like Reddish and Edgeley and more posh like Cheadle and Cheadlehome, and then there's Marple and Romilly and Bredbury and Gatley and Davenport, and I bet there's parts of Argentina that go, I don't know how this happened, the price since boundary change, we now bother Stockport. I don't know. There's about 30 places called Heaton. There's Heaton Chapel and Heaton Norris. I love how even within the Heatons, there's a hierarchy. You've got Heaton Norris, which is the slightly less posh entry-level gateway Heaton. And then there's Heaton Moor and Heaton Chapel. Heaton Mersey. There's Heaton Academicals. There's... There's such a mix that in one five-minute walk, you can pass a row of back-to-back houses, a micro-brewery, lads in hoodies sniffing drain cleaner, a park with a Tudor manor house, a football ground where even the pitch is made of rusty corrugated iron, a motorway, a glass pyramid, a Waitrose with 900 flavours of asparagus, a nightclub you can get in free if you bring your own chainsaw. It's... Stockport's like a kid's drawing. You expect the next row to have an iceberg and an astronaut and a dinosaur. And everything seems to be a bit of a mixture of part rough and part grand. A headline in the Manchester Evening News said, Stockport gang see man get arrested, then break into his home while he's out to steal his vacuum cleaner. That's so Stockport! For example, Edgeley was where I first developed an affection for Stockport, 2001, because I came to Edgeley Park, where Stockport County were playing my team, Crystal Palace, and Palace won with a goal 3 minutes from the end. So we all came out, and at the traffic lights, this car drove up and a woman wound the window down and she just went to me, next year I hope you do get relegated, and then I hope you get relegated again and again and again and again and again. She said, and I hope you get relegated so many times you end up in Scottish League. But it seems there's always been this side to Stockport. There's a book I've got there, Stockport, A History, which is written to show off the joys of the town. And it starts with the boast, Stockport is what Stockport was, an irregular, ill-built, dirty place that no traveller would ever wish to see again. But this is unfair, because it did have famous travellers. Karl Marx and Frederick Engels came here, and Engels said, Stockport is renowned as one of the duskiest, smokiest holes and looks, especially when viewed from the viaduct, excessively repellent. Engels went on, last week I was arrested for seditious and revolutionary activities, and when I was released, I discovered some bastard had nicked my vacuum cleaner. The River Mersey comes through Stockport, the most famous and iconic of any British river. And you've done it, proud Stockport, because where has Liverpool... Liverpool has only given it a ferry and a few anthems, but you've treated it properly. You've paved over it and put a Primark on it. Every single person I've met here has asked me the question, which football club is nearest to the River Mersey? Not Liverpool or Everton, it's Stockport. And you're proud of this, because that is the main thing with a football club. Real Madrid might keep winning European Cup, but they're miles from Mersey, so it don't count. It's all about going somewhere, Stockport. You're right next to the M60. You've got famous railways. You've got the airport nearby. And you've got the most famous bus route in the world, which is Stockport, the...
192.
The 192 from Stockport to Manchester, which has become the most celebrated method of transport. Like the Orient Express or the... or the Apollo 11, or the Stockport Twitter account. Someone has summarised the atmosphere it creates, writing, they should bottle the smell of the 192 bus and use it as a weapon in war. This is the sort of exchange you read about on the 192. On a forum, somebody wrote, ah, the 192, does the shirtless man with a rabbit still get on? And the next person replied, he's the driver, mate. What is it? Have you all been on it?
Yeah.
It? You get used to it. I know, I've been on it, and I can see it, and you get used to it. A bloke will sit next to you and go, yeah, all right, mate, my name's Kelvin. Of course, that's not my real name. You know, the M60, I own all the cones on it. Only as far as Denton, like, you know. Yeah, I tell you what, me and my mates do. On a Sunday, we ski down the side of the pyramid building, like, you know what I mean? This is my stop. If anyone asks, I'm Kelvin, and I. I went on it on a Monday night. I thought, right, just one little trip on it. Nothing's going to happen, is it? And honestly, this is true. Honestly, there's a bloke at the bus stop, and he went, hey, mate, and I, hey, we might have 2 minutes, or we might have 20 minutes. You know what I mean? He said, what should we talk about? He said, you can have the Beatles or Beethoven. I said, what's your favourite Beatles song? He said, what's yours? I said, I Am the Walrus. And straight away he went, sitting on a cornflake, waiting for the bus to come. I said, that's brilliant, mate. That was brilliant to think of that quick. And then it came and we got on and he said, and my favourite Beethoven symphony is the third. He said, it was only when my brother was dying that I realised how powerful that symphony was. And then he went, I am the Eggman. I am the Eggman. And it was very moving, and it made me wonder whether the 192 is not actually a bus route, it's a travelling theatre. And the passengers all get back to the garage and go, oh, Sir Kenick, your alcoholic war veteran was a triumph. Now, there is a possible explanation for why some people are a bit eccentric here, because this was the centre of the profession known for sending people peculiar, the hat business. The damp air at the foot of the Pennines, I'm sure you all know, it was perfect for making felt, and there were dozens of hat factories. And you get the impression that the hat trade was a very, very fun trade to be part of. For example, the solution that the felt was treated by was made with sulfuric acid, mercury and meths. And the foreman...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.